about an app, Deep Space 3D, new digital tool for 3D space syntax analysis.
Well, this presentation will be some of the presentations last week, yesterday. I had the possibility was late to present one of the parts I want to show you. The commercial part. There was a scientific part of the presentation that I will try to merge in one single presentation. Well, the first thing to do is to say that 3D analysis of in-space syntax is not absolutely necessary, but it can bring new tools of analysis. New tools for analysis in the great concept of space syntax technologies. Well, this is a well-known icon of Borto. It's not in use today. I think it has been changed for another one, but you see there the torch flares is an icon of Porto, and is an icon by some reason. And that reason has also some spatial, some spatial is, well, it's a consequence of some spatial condition. Torch flares is here. This is a nice vista of the torch flares, 2D analysis, you can see. And well, this square here is that yellow square there, and Porto is that represented there. It's difficult how can torch flares be such a mark in Porto when this vista is this area? Well, because 2D representation is not sufficient to represent the importance. And in this picture, of course, we can see that the plane, the 2D representation is not sufficient. Well, it's official of torch flares, there are some pictures. It's not a complete dissolution, this is taken from the high point of the tower. Not complete, but as you can see, nothing to see this real isovista with representation. Well, this is one of the cases. Reality that cannot be, surely cannot be represented by a 2D analysis. Well, there are other cases where this can, it's very well explicitly well demonstrated in reality. For example, when we have volumetric very convoluted volumetric volumes, if we analyze only one 2D analysis, it's not possible to gain all the richness of the reality. This is Rauch. And not only the volumes, but we also see that the relation between interior and exterior it's not possible to completely moderate the noise. This is another case. I am only showing some situations here in Porto, with Casa da Música, where there is no 2D representation possible because all the levels are very intricate. It's not really possible to get a 2D representation, a very fine 2D representation. And of course, when you want to analyze it in 3D, it would be very big. Well, it's not in, only to say, it's not only in new buildings, also in, this is for other colleagues, some of you know that. And the interior, it's a Baroque church. Baroque has very dynamic volume, interior volume modulation. So, also in very ancient buildings, this problem arises and it has to be with some other tools. Of course, I think it's the last one, it is FOCO, Neighborhood in Porto. I'm showing this because they will be trying to modulate to demonstrate the validity of 3D analysis. This is has been exhaustively studying 2D space index analysis, and well, the researcher who made that, she already presented the analysis she has made, and she was analyzing this situation, she thought that 2D analysis could not analyze. She was analyzing the relationships between functional spaces, for example, she could not relate all the visibility of high-rise buildings with the common space, the public space. It was completely taken by the order to the analysis, because the high-rise buildings have much more visibility than into the was possible to get. But this is the modulation. I will bring back this slide. Well, space syntax is highly consuming calculus, and that only can be made by numerical methods, by computers. It's absolutely necessary to have digital tools to treat those kind of problems. And so, well, there are no full 3D analysis in space syntax, no digital tools in 3D available in the market. As to say, market, in the academic community. I think there is one we have not analyzed. Another one to a GIS software commercial Spain application, but we have not seen any mark of that software in any paper we have seen, so we don't know how deeply that software is used. And the countries of that software, well, yeah, all the formal methods team here in the school decided to make a software tool that would be given to the community, the academic community, to use in spatial syntax analysis. Well, it's what I'm going to present now here. Well, some concepts. Very, very brief concepts, not deeply. This is to the visibility analysis. What to do in the reality? The first spatial reality where we are talking in 2D spatial reality. The first thing, it cuts some slice of spatial reality relatively to the remaining world. The remaining world does not have any interest to the analysis. That is a very big problem, because space syntax, I will tell something to you later, but space syntax is an operation, space syntax analysis is an operation that has not transitivity property, so when we get something, we will have some problems with the rest of the world. But I will talk something about later. Well, we got this. This is nothing. And then, in the space we are analyzing, we divide it into two parts. One is the active part, where the social and human activities really occur. And there are some black boxes where we don't know what exists, we don't know to know. They are black boxes. The only thing they do is making some obstacle to the human activities. Third thing we do is analyzing the relationship between any two points of the active space with we want to make a function relating those two, any two points of that active space. Well, space syntax has one big quantity that it analyzes, and it is visibility. So, the human activity that space syntax analyzes in the reality is the visual action. There are many other actions, but space syntax primarily is dedicated to that one. And it depends in the theory that is related to the technique, that this is very important to study many phenomena in the behavior of humans in that space. It has many consequences, social, psychological, material, and so on. Although other quantities sometimes appear, but this is the central idea. Visual activity from the humans in that active space is the most meaningful activity. Well, we are now arriving to a revision of this idea when trying to pass the former situation into B to another situation in C. And although the team developing this was not interested in making a great revision of the space syntax paradigms and the analysis, well, we had to make some new considerations. There was a critique, a review of some concepts that had to be made because what I said about 2D, those three or four great ideas were not completely applicable in 3D. You know that when we grow up in dimensions, in some mathematical formulation, there are problems that, well, it's not just appending or summing one more dimension and everything remains the same. There are consequences between one dimension with the other dimension, and that what appears here, Coriolis effect, is something you all know, the interrelations between the several dimensions of space, and basically when some material process, physical or visual or anything, happens in that space, it's transformed by the new number of dimensions. Well, first thing is in the consideration of what I call the active space. In 2D, there is a relation between any two points, and the relation of visibility between any two points of the active space. But the visibility function is very easy. Well, it has a domain. It is all the points of the visibility of the active space, and the counter domain is a boolean. Is yes or no, or true or false. It sees or it does not see from one point to the other point. It is bijective. Well, Tassos called yesterday, talked something about this. In the strict formulation, short formulation of space syntax is bijective. If this point sees that point, the inverse is true. You can see that the general formulation of the visibility function. Not difficult. Well, in this case, we 3D, we have to make some critique of that point. Well, in the first place, when we are talking of modulating some reality, we have to adjust our considerations in the model to be something that represents reality. Well, you can see that in 2D, not all the points see view the other points, because it's not the space axis, it's the humans. Humans are the active persons, the active agents here. We have not considered that every point in the space is seeing the other points of the space. This is a modulation creation of the model that fits better to the real situation, and it has a greater advantage there in the calculations, because if you have to relate any two points of
an app, Deep Space 3D, really helpful for 3D space syntax analysis.
Well, this presentation will be some of the presentations last week to yesterday. I the possibility of late to present one of the part I want to show you. The commercial part. And there was a scientific part of the presentation that I will try to merge in one single presentation. Well, the first thing to do is to say that 3D analysis of in space syntax is not absolutely necessary, but it kind of brings new tools of analysis. New tools for analysis in the but in the great concept of space index technologies. Well, this is a well-known icon of Porto. It's not in use today. I think it has been changed for another one, but you see there the Torres Claris is an icon of Porto. And it's an icon by some reason. And that reason has also some spatial some spatial is, well, it's a consequence of some spatial condition. Torres Claris is here. This is a nice vista of the Torres Claris in a 2D analysis, you can see. And well, this square here is that yellow square there, and Porto is that area represented there. It's difficult how can Torres Claris be such a mark in Porto when it's obviously is this area? Well, because to the representation is not sufficient to represent the importance. And in this picture, of course, we can see that the plane, the 2D representation is not sufficient. Well, it's obvious that Torres Claris has some pictures. It's not a complete, it's obvious that this is taken from high point of the tower, not complete, but as you can see, nothing to see this Rio Isovista with representation. Well, this is one of the cases and reality that cannot be, surely cannot be represented by a 2D analysis. Well, there are other cases where this can explicitly demonstrate in reality. For example, when we have volumetric very convoluted volumetric volumes, if we analyze only one 2D analysis, it's not possible to gain all the richness of the reality. This is ours, and not only the volumes, but we also see that the relation between interior and exterior. It's not possible to completely modulate with the analysis. This is another case. I am only showing some situations here in Porto, in Casa da Música, where there is no 2D representation possible because all the levels are very intricate. It's not really possible to get a 2D representation, a very fine 2D representation, and of course when you want to analyze it in 3D, it would be very difficult. Well, it's not in, only to say it's not only in new buildings, also in, this is the Torres Claris, some of you know that. And the interior, it's a Baroque church. Baroque has very dynamic volume, interior volume modulation. So also in very ancient buildings, this problem arises and has to be with some other tools. Of course, I think it's the last one, it is focal. Never losing Porto. I showing this because Zeboli tried to modulate to demonstrate the validity of 3D analysis. this is a, has been exhaustively studying 2D space index analysis, and well, the researcher who made that, she already presented the analysis she has made, and she was analyzing this situation, she thought that 2D analysis could not analyze. She was analyzing the relationships between functional spaces, and for example, she cannot, she could not be able to relate all the visibility of high-rise buildings with the common space, the public space. It was completely taken by the order to the analysis, because the high-rise buildings have much more visibility than into the was possible to get. So this is the modulation. I will bring back this slide. Well, space syntax is highly consuming calculus, and that only can be made by numerical methods, by computers. It's absolutely necessary to have digital tools to treat those kind of problems. And so, well, there are no full 3D analysis in space syntax, no digital tools in 3D available in the market, as to say market, in the academic community. I think there is one we have not analyzed, another one to GIS software commercial Spain application, but we have not seen any mark of that software in any paper we have seen, so we don't know how that software is used. And the characteristics of that software, well, our formal methods team here in the school decided to make a software tool that would be given to the community, the academic community, to use in spatial syntax analysis. Well, it's what I'm going to present now here. Well, some concepts, very brief concepts, not deeply. This is 2D visibility analysis. What to do in the reality. First, spatial reality, where we are talking in 2D spatial reality. The first thing, it cuts some slice of spatial reality relatively to the remaining world. The remaining world does not as any interest to the analysis. That is a very big problem, because space syntax, I will tell something later, but space syntax is an operation, space syntax analysis operation that has not transitivity property, so when we get something, we will have some problems with the rest of the world. But I will talk something about later. Well, we got this is nothing. And then, in the space we are analyzing, we divide it into two parts. One is the active part, where the social and human activities really occur. And there are some black boxes where we don't know what exists we don't know to know. They are black box. The only thing they do is making some obstacle to the human activities. Third thing we do is analyzing the relationship between any two points of the active space with we want to make a function relating those two any two points of the active space. Well, space syntax has one big quantity that it analyzes, and it is visibility. So, the human activity that space syntax analyzes in the reality is the visual action. There are many other actions, but space syntax primarily is dedicated to that one. And it depends in the theory that is related to the technique, that this is very important to study many phenomena in the behavior of humans in that space. It has many consequences, social, psychological, material, and so on. Although other quantities sometimes appear, but this is the central idea. Visual activity from the humans in that active space is the most meaningful activity. Well, we are now arriving to a revision of this idea when trying to pass the from a situation in 2D to another situation in 3D. And although the team developing this was not interested in making a great revision of the space syntax paradigms and the basis, well, we had to make some new considerations. There was a critique, a review of some concepts that had to be made because that what I said about to the those three or four great ideas were not completely applicable in the three. You know that when we grow up in dimensions in some mathematical formulation, there are problems that, well, it's not just appending of suddenly one more dimension and everything remains the same. There are consequences between one dimension with the other dimension, and that what appears here, Coriolis effect, is something you all know, the interrelations between the several dimensions of space, and basically when some material process, physical or visual or anything, happens in that space, it's transformed when the number of the dimensions grow. Well, first thing is in the consideration of what I call the active space. In 2D, there is a relation between any two points and the relation of visibility between any two points of the between any two points of the active space. The visibility function is very easy. Well, it has a domain. It is all the points of the visibility of the active space, and the counter domain is a boolean, is yes or no, or true or false. It sees or it does not see, from one point to the other point. It is bijective. Well, Tassos called yesterday talked something about this. In the strict formulation, short formulation of space syntax, it is activist. This point is the point the inverse is true. You can see that the general formulation of the visibility function. Not this point. Well, in this case, we 3D, we have to make some critique of that, that point. Well, in the first place, when we are talking of modulating some reality, we have to adjust our considerations in the model to be something that represents reality. Well, you can see that in 2D, not all the points see, view the other points, because it's not the space axis, it's the humans. Humans are the active persons, the active agents here. We have not considered that every point in the space is seeing the other points of the space. This is a modulation creation of the model that fits better to the real situation, and it has a great advantage there in the calculations, because if you have to relate any two points of the volume in consideration, well, it will be a huge space of analysis. Although if we can limit some of the points, well, this is a great advantage to the solution of the problem. It will be minute, it's much more easier to treat a space with much less volume than if you can reduce something in the volume, that is a very, very good situation. So we divide the space, the volume, in some volume where people can be, and then the other volume where people cannot be, and there is no necessity to consider that volume as a seen volume. And then the result, the other volume is considered a view space. One sees, the other is seen. Well, this viewed space can be also considered as accumulation of two different situations. Let's see, there's something. No, not yet, but later. You will be. Well, then we have the obstacle space. The black boxes you saw there in the 2D simulation no longer exist. They are not black box, they are considered in our model, 3D model, surfaces. And they are not, there is not necessity to consider them close. Well, the great advantage of closing those spaces is that those surfaces here represented by straight lines, could be not a straight line, but a line, however, has only one visibility, and this, the other visibility from the other face is not considered. This is a great advantage for 2D analysis, but it is a limitation, because there are spaces that are not treated, they are not analyzed. Well, we didn't thought that it was a good solution, and we made the assumption that we could treat this with surfaces that not enclosure and volume, and that those surfaces has not only one side, but has two sides. Well, I'm perhaps confounding something, because those surfaces, when they are seen from one side to another, they don't belong to obstacle space, but to the view space. And that is why, because in reality, although they are obstacle space and view space are conceptually different, but they represent the same reality. Well, the surfaces we have here, for example, they are obstacles to our visibility, but they are also seen. Well, they belong to the two spaces, the obstacle space and the view space. Although view space has another component, and it's the air, the volume. We can see any point, although there is no material, not material. We have the possibility to say if something was here, for example, what would be its visibility. And we maintain that possibility. So the view space has two parts. One are the surfaces that are here also, and the other is the whole volume, the possible volume to be analyzed as a view space. Well, in the obstacle space, we consider also this possibility is that it is not completely opaque. It can be something with some degree of opacity or transparency. So what we considered was these three possibilities. First, a degree of transparency of opacity in the global space. For example, simulating no fog, for example, where are some loss of the visibility along the meters we have to see, right? And the surfaces also could have some degree of opacity or not. That is to say that this surface can be an obstacle surface or not. If there is total visibility, it continues to belong to the viewed space, but not to the obstacle surface. And there is a sudden loss of visibility in the surface, and beyond the surface, there could be also a loss of visibility, but only behind that surface. Well, I think I have the complete definition of the three spaces we consider, and well, the visibility function changed a little. First, it's not objective, it's always from one viewpoint to a viewed point, from a person to some space, and then it's not zero or one, true or false, but something between zero and one. Well, Tassos yesterday also talked about the revolutions in the space index in the same direction. This is a typical example of 2D visibility analysis. And we have to transform this in a 3D visibility analysis. What changes? It's not from one point to another point. It's from one point where people can stay to all the other points. some in the volume, in 3D volume, and some in the surfaces that here represent those lines. Well, the visibility in 2D is analyzed only in the ground. Those surfaces, well, it's what is in the ground next to the line that represents the surface. When we have 3D, of course, what is here is not what is in over surface. We have to analyze the surface in several situations, in several points. The volume, we have to analyze, well, the ground is also a surface because it's a real surface because it's something we can see. Well, this surface maintains its respectability in 3D. Those surfaces are added. The whole volume is also added, and there is another the view space that sees all those elements there. There can be any possibility of opacity or visibility between the viewer and the viewed things through some poster. Well, I think I resume. I create a little abstract of what I intend to say. Well, this is a 3D analysis, very simple. And you can see what I was just saying. Here is the surface, the ground surface. Those are some surfaces that are in the 3D space. They are also seen. And this is a slice of the volume that is represented here, says what is seen or not seen in the volume. Of course, we can have slices of the volume in, well, not only in that position, but in other positions. Well, this is the conceptual model. And, well, we have to see how this conceptual model could be modeled by a real model in terms of the real software development. Well, I'm talking something now about the operational model that the software real deals with. First decision. There are three topological representations of in space syntax by degree of abstraction. First is the volume and surfaces topological representation. Then here we can have with some abstraction, because we only analyze the main lines, the actual main lines in that space. It's the second representation usual current in a space syntax analysis. And then we have a more abstract one is graph analysis, where, for example, those points are represented for some square, some room, and so on. Well, generally, there are four points that are crosses in the actual map, or then what is called convex spaces. In a convex space, for example, this room would be a convex space in the space syntax current analysis. Well, this is a non-metric, it's purely topological, it's non-metric representation. So there is no 2D or 3D in here. It's completely irrelevant, the consideration of the 3D representation in here. Well, in this case, it's not so. Axial maps are generally used in urban studies. And as you can see in the portal, well, those actual lines are not really, well, in the same level. Porto is not a right town, and if you have to climb a little. So there is some advantage in treating these axial maps with strings. Although there are several software tools that can deal with axial maps with a plugin tree, and well, they are in use today, they are available and used. And well, we decided to give a link with this power. Well, the most complex problem, because it has much more information than this one. And we saw that it was in this topological representation that we had to invest, because it was where 3D can shine. It's in that topological representation that 3D can bring the most of the best results. Well, second operation. We are cutting our problem. Was to be the second operation was to decide if we analyze, we create that visibility function I told you, if that visibility function would be continuous or discrete. Continuous, that is to say, well, it is a reality, the space is continuous. You can have a point here or here, here. It's continuous positions. We can move in continuous manner. Well, you say the domain of the visibility function is well, two continuous spaces. Well, we academically tried to see if there was a possibility to treat this in analytical method. Analytical solutions in mathematics are most expedite, they are very quick to solve. Trust me, there are many operations but have a very terrible problem. Well, the mathematical tools to treat them are not available in the most of the cases. It's in this case absolutely not absolutely true. We tried solutions, but it was in the beginning we knew that we had to treat this problem, to deal with this problem with some kind of discretization of space, and then treat the problem with numerical mathematical tools. I'm not going to say how we could treat this in an analytical way. This was really insane. Then what we just did was to divide those three spaces we have in some discretization technique. What we have made, well, here, for example, I can show you the view space. It's the view space is a space where people can be. It's represented by points. Well, the view space are points in space, only the points where people can be. Of course, we have no limitation for the position of that points, so they must be represented by XYZ. There is another thing that master creator has a point, is that if it's not, we must assign a volume to that point. For example, if I consider a point representing some volume, well, that point can represent less volume, and so on. So we have to add another parameter to the point, not only x, y, z position, but also the volume the point represented. And that is completely defined. Well, then we have the viewpoints. We make in the viewed space also discretization. The volume, the global volume is discretized also in points. Well, although the software application orientates people, users, to do a regular distribution through the three axes, through X, Y, and Z, it's possible, it's not impossible to make other distribution. So the points in the volume, the global volume, is represented by X, Y, Z, and also a volume. In the surfaces, in the other part of the viewed space, the surfaces are strictly discretized in triangles. And in those triangles, there are created two other possibilities. Well, why in triangles? Well, I discuss this, but when we make any software application, and we treat a geometry problem in 3D, it's a natural thing we do. When you play in a console fun game, all the graphics are made of triangles. We could make an argument, but it's very, very hard to. Well, in orthogonal, well, God make the word triangular in geometric representation, but we insist in making almost always some cubic works. Architecture, most of the architectural works are orthogonal and moving parallelepipedal and so on. So we have to, this is not without problem, as you see, especially in visualization, you see some problems that occur when we do this. But it's not a very difficult problem. The triangles can simulate any surface curve, very complicated. Triangles can, in this example, only orthogonal things, but can be any kind of surface, also in the ground. It has not been a flat surface, can be anything. Well, the obstacles. Obstacles are the pure triangles. Well, we did not make any discretization of the obstacles. Well, surfaces are not discretized, they are the surfaces. The surfaces are not discretized in as intended as obstacles, but are discretized in what they are as viewed places, and they are discretized in triangles, and those triangles, there are two solutions with some difference to the view, to the user. Some divide those you see. Well, you see here is a surface divided by well, the ground is represented here by two triangles, and those two triangles are the obstacles. Those little triangles are the same thing that treats as a built space. This represents the built space as a global volume, and is treated the central points here are the points that are currently analyzed. Well, I think I have told you the base of all the software application. And now I'm trying to say you something about other operational features. First of one is the viewing space, where people are. These points can be aggregated in paths, in routes, to simulate several situations. For example, visiting the tourist tour, commerce tour, some other, any kind of population, we can divide it in paths. For example, there are paths for Asia, all other paths for any other thing. You can divide as you like, you attribute, you say there are paths. I don't know how to say this. It's funny in English. It's very, very difficult to me. But you know what I'm talking about. This is something that exists in regular and current 2D spatial syntax analysis. The concept of pass. And we maintain here this concept. We have in the software application, we have decided to put it in a other hierarchical situation. There are main passes that may have sub-passes, later they can be analyzed in the main ways. Well, the same thing relatively to the viewed space. We can say that the viewed space belongs to some property. For example, is a space that is commercial space, is industrial space, is leisure space. Well, I'm not inside the dwelling. We can say that is a room or an office, living room, and so on. We can say what we want. I'm talking only about functional attributes to those spaces, but not necessarily. You can say whatever you want about them. Well, another feature. Database. But the software application has, in fact, two parts, as any software application. One is the algorithm, the program, and the other is the data. Well, we divide, that is very well known, the computation theory. Algorithm plus data equal application. That's the And that division is well marked on the proposition. It is a great advantage because the database is completely available to the users. They can do, well, the algorithm makes some transformation, reads, transforms, and writes in the database. But you can do it also by other algorithms that you would like to use. If you want to do some statistical analysis on every quantity represented, you can do it. Well, there are really not one database, but two databases. One database is the same for all the projects you deal with the program. The other database, well, it saves the data and the results, input data and output data of each process. Of each project you will deal with the application. Here, I will talk about it later. Well, it's many information in the database, but I can tell that what really matters is only 10% of this. All the other data is for the sake of user interface. User interface is one thing that we were, when we intended to do this, the software application is something we thought that would be a very useful, very user friendly, and so we invested most of all programming effort in the user interface, and this reflects in the database. For example, we have here information of the viewpoints. The viewpoints, only thing that matters is XYZ for the core business of calculations, XYZ and the volume, and so on. Only 10% of the information is there is really information about this wall. About space index, everything else is about user interface. So, repeating, this is the possibility that the users, well-trained users, have to pick information here and to create some kind of transformation of that database. This can serve, for example, to pick information about geometric project, geometric information about the project, and translate it to AutoCAD, for example. Can be done without interfering with the program. It's another thing. It reads space index. Or the same thing, we can go to AutoCAD, design a project, and pick the information from AutoCAD and put here that information for the exchange. For exchanging information from and to this database, it will be useful. Well, I must say, this database is developed now in Access. It's a very well-known database from Microsoft, database management system from Microsoft. In the near future, we will put it in also in SQL Server. It's almost the same thing, although SQL Server is more open and free. This is not free, but the use of the program that the program do with this database is free. You don't have to buy access to have this information. Another feature of the program is relatively to derive concepts. What is calculated by our program is the visibility function. It calculates this code that I am going to give to say how this calculate the visibility function. Well, there are two quantities that I calculate between the viewpoints and the viewing points. The point at C and the point at EC. Well, it's Cartesian product from all points at C to all points that are seen. That is the visibility function, and this relation of any point of one space to any point of other space, we call it a Cartesian space, a Cartesian product, has, well, two quantities that we calculate. The first one is the distance, the second one is the visibility, that, as you said, as I said you, it can be something from 0 to 1. Well, from these two quantities, you can build every space syntax quantity by some transformation of this information. And it's what we try to do, so that we can create, use the, well, I don't know, but I don't know if you know, but space syntax quantities are always growing. Begin to be 10, then someone thought that those are quantities, always transformations about the visibility function. Well, we have more 10, again, the next analysis. This is several dozens of years now, having new quantities. Well, we can do this by some process. I would not say that the program admits the introduction of any of these, but of these quantities, but well, is disponible, it's available for the user to introduce his own quantities. This is the through, well, we are talking about the database, through a language that is called SQL Query. It's a very well-known language for database managers, those who deal with database, standard language. For example, the definition of ISOVISTA in SQL query in our database is there. That SQL query definition creates ISOVISTA. And then we can do whatever we want with that isolation. Isolation connectivity, any of the quantities you'd like. Well, I would say it is easy. We are trying to, because non-trained, non-skilled users will not be aware, they cannot build those things because it's not useful for those who cannot deal with SQL queries. Although the division in two databases that I have told you before, except one of the databases can be, it's the database used for all projects you build with. And that database can be added by anyone. So anyway, we are intending to download to you and use the database any improvements then that the user community is about to do on the software, so you can use all those new quantities that the community has added. Well, this is the easiest definition in SQL. More visual vista, because it goes directly to the visibility function. Other than, well, if this is the easiest you would say in Chinese, it's not very easy. But yeah, we are trying to give you what ever the community will bring in new. For example, the Sky Factor you will be used to, it can be translated here in the SQL way. Well, SQL way has a lot of possibilities in statistical analysis, so not very not those more complicated, but it has that possibility. And then we have another possibility, is to access the programming language. We are not only making the possibility to download the user program, but also the source code. It was developed under Microsoft Visual Studio. It's also a very well-known development environment for commercial applications. We decided that type of environment because those kind of environments are very well suited for applications that the user interface, where the user interface is most wanted. Well, I'm changing here something and I will show you. Of the program. As you see, it's the user interface is what you are used to. To see the commercial application, I highly recommend that you use high resolutions. This is not good because this part of the in this resolution, in every resolution, this part is needed for the user interface, and this is used for the drawings. Well, in full RGB, this part is from here to here, and this is only a little part here. This resolution is not good for this kind of problems. Well, this was to show you some possibilities you have. You may change many things in the layout, project dimensions, position of the camera, normally what you can do in a CAD system, position of the camera, and many lights of the. Well, this is to brighten the application, not very important for the scientific outputs you would like to have. Powers. I'm not going to explain all the things. Important here is the surfaces. Here you can build and manage, for example, delete or create or copy do anything you want with those surfaces, change position, right, translation, rotation, deformation, what you want as a CAD, although it's not a full CAD as you can see, no? To do a full CAD we have to do 1,000 programmers to do that, and that was not the case, but it's not bad in those things. Always was made that in the past that those viewing points, the viewing points are defined in the past, you can create the same thing. They are represented there by triangles. You can create how many paths you want and relate to them with one another in a hierarchical way. You have another possibility to generate some forms. You don't need to create triangle. You can create forms, complete forms, several forms. You also have a geometry generator. You can generate geometry generators so that you may make other forms that you can use later. If you want this form, you have only to... Okay, this is not the same. You have only to write some few data. It's easier to create the geometries than triangle to triangle. And then, I'm going to show you another. I want to raise the button for that in this little resolution. I didn't see everything. I was somewhere. Well, this is another example, it's very simple, it's already populated, and population of this minute or 2 minutes when they are very little, when they are very big, it's very difficult, I will tell in a moment. What you can see about this, showed you. you can see all the surfaces. Well, I will show you the hidrovistas for the pass. It's a global volume for all the pass, for all the points in the pass I choose, its main pass. And this is the problem and the problem. I can put any slice. Well, this represents the positions where I populated the slices. The quantum between the slices was 5 meters, and this represents the positions I can. Okay, and so on. I have another representation, only for something like the medical, all the slices in one direction with all the all the positions where the slice is. Well, I cannot see this. I'm not able to see the rest of it. But all the slices appear here if I have enough space. Well, there is a representation that I have not used. In this version I had, I walked away, it was another one. It's the representation of the path of the viewpoints. The viewpoints also can be seen and with the color. The points that view more are red, those points that view less are blue. And as this observation, I can see all the other quantities I have. I assume it's the last thing. I have been told that I passed my time for a long time ago. I'm open to your questions. And I say that we are Tassos is working on it, and a group in the Bartlett School, also in the Architectural Association. We have a group that is using the program to tell us the problems they use the program, but it were still early versions of the program. I have been in Lisbon to the Faculty of Architecture showing the problem. I will tell you pre-alpha versions. We intended, it was our intention, to bring a better version, maybe to say not commercial version, but a version stabilized. The version is almost stabilized, but we have not yet a full manual. That for an end user would be absolutely necessary. So, but in a very short time, all of you will be invited to download the program and use it, and you send back your considerations. You will maintain the program. I think that. Please feel free to make any questions.
I would like to know what's the equivalent for the the or an axial map in the 3D version, like a set of planes?
Or? Yes, axial map. Not, we are not treating that problem just now. Of course, it would be nice to create axial maps with the information you also have introduced here. Well, that was one discussion. What is an axial map in 3D? Basically, it's not very difficult because an axial map is not really the 3D map, but only the map, the axial line of the view space. And the view space, in fact, is not, it can be, it's not, all the space could be could be a view space, but normally it's some kind of surface. So we could define also axial lines using only the paths of the view space, only the viewpoints. So that discussion is precise. What is an axial line in 3D? It's a discussion we have to make. Make it when we decided to create axial lines in here. Well, something that well, I must do. Hours to modulate. It's not much. Well, you can see here the viewpoints. The viewpoints are not only on the ground, but also in the windows. You could say everything where the window we put is fault. Well, this is made some days ago. We put it in the calculus. It has 5,000 viewpoints and 70,000 viewpoints. Well, that is something as 35 million the cross product one by another. And there are several cells in the surface, obstacle surfaces. You see, you couldn't, well, it did not end in the, and I did something was to, I put it in three parallel computers. So then I saw that this was too much in time in one computer. This is not featured in the program, but I can do it. It's not difficult. Perhaps it will be available in several computers working in parallel to deal with those problems. But what I want to say is, well, for the moment, there are very serious time issues in the use of the program, and they are very big. Well, there are little, little problems you saw. In 1 or 2 minutes sufficient. Very large problems. More questions? Well, I discussed a lot with Tassos some 2 or 3 months ago, these time problems to say, because he has better algorithms than I have in printing 3D. Although he has not a user interface for that calculus, and I have a user interface. Well, we are going to merge some of the qualities of one and another.
How did you manage to make the to implement the algorithm for days of business? Did you make a sphere or a series of normals to the sphere and calculate whether
it's daylight from one point to another point, and we see if it intersects any of the obstacle surfaces, the triangles. It's not a very, no. For those of course, it's not a very difficult analytical geometry problem. It's treated in every computer game that you see. Anyhow, you have you see what is in the front, you don't see what is in the end. It's well, not very difficult. Of course, you need to know the molecular geometry or some other of those disciplines, mathematical disciplines, it's not straight.
It would be nice to have a parsing from CAD, no? To know where the points go in the database to create faces and stuff.
Yes, we already discussed the list.
A little plugin for parsing points.
Yes, as you can see, here we have to modulate the geometrical project again. If you do this in architect has to do the project and then he has to do another again the same thing. But it must be said that it's difficult to, as you know, maybe the 2D programs have import from AutoCAD, for example, but it's much easier to import a 2D drawing, because the lines in only one 2D space, it's easy to understand that. But what do I import from in 3D, from 3D? Some CADs, like original AutoCAD, we don't even know what is a volume. Well, you know what is a volume in AutoCAD, for example. But what is important in the model to transport here? Well, it's not very easy.
There is a language from
they have a language. Yes, for example, AutoCAD has something.
Polygon, point,
yes.
And then circuit, point.
Yes, point. Yes. It's not easy in any way. The exchange formats from CADs, you know that is something like line to transform line in the volume. I'm talking about VXF. It's a standard for. It's not possible with that language. But there are languages. AutoCAD has
CSV, so with.
Yes, AutoCAD has, for example, VBScript. As VBScript. Is a language. VB comes from Visual Basic, that is also used in the development of these programs, so it's not syntactically very different. It could be impossible. Although it is not trivial, we are intending to do that. We are going to do that, but not immediately. There is another thing, that in the architectural project, from the architectural project, we need only 1% of the information, or less. You can see that the information, geometric information here, and from the project of the focal, nothing is 1,000, 110,000 information of the real project. So. It's not easy to say what is important and not. The detail in the project is something you don't need, and it's absolutely annoyable in the creation of these simplified models.
The could be made in a CAD, but it could be made properly,
yes.
Properly.
Yes, over CAD would be much better.
For these aspects,
yes, yes, yes.
It could be modeled there, and
yes, yes.
Exported like text, in the heading and the
of course, of course. And for example, ASCII is better, because we can create objects adapted to the export for you. You create those objects and it will be very good. ASCII is also a database philosophy, also the same thing. Well, but I'm saying, Catarina developed all his work on 2D index map to be from the Barclay. And, well, he modulated everything. We saw the drawings, it was not, she didn't import the, I think, you didn't import all the geometrical data, you made everything in the depth map.
No, I imported my drawings.
Yeah, oh, you developed in ARCHICAD, you transformed, okay. But not in the project. She made in ARCHICAD the new what he interested, and then she exported to depth map. Well, we can do everything.
Yeah.
But it's a limitation that we are trying to solve. Well, thank you.